are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Short hair, and I got to my sort of late 40s, and I decided California, I need long hair. So I looked into different brands, and Chris did, of hair extensions, always wanting long, luscious hair, because my own hair is so fine. So we tried different companies, and we found Hair Dreams. So I have them myself, all the models. You're going to be inspired about what you can do with Hair Dreams. And then at 2:45 in room 315, we're going to take you through every single model in depth, piece by piece. And you'll be able to look through the extensions at that time.
Well, as you can see, the collection we put together is like a look into young Hollywood. It's taking inspirations from the past, bringing it up to date to the present, and really using influences from certain movie stars that we've seen and become icons to us. And what I want to do is explore that feeling of looking at, you know, like I know from myself from being a kid, I used to look at the movies and I used to sketch out like ideas that I'd see in the movies. I'd see these beautiful kind of women and I'd sketch the ideas and I'd kind of like put a little twist on it. And now it's like having live, basically it's like having live Barbie dolls, because every single one of these girls we've been able to kind of play with, we've been able to put the new quickies from Hair Dreams in every single one of their hair. And quickies is this kind of like little formula of extensions that you it takes about an hour to put together. That's all it takes to kind of go into the hair. So to be able to lengthen or thicken someone's hair in less than an hour is actually a kind of a miracle. Every single one of the models you're seeing in front of you has had quickies in their hair. We're going to be doing two classes on the quickies so you can actually see us doing the applications and working with them. But the whole feeling here, as you can kind of see, is getting texture, whether it's soft and silky, or whether it's loads of volume. And every single one of our models kind of like has actually been amazed at how much more hair they've got in there in a very natural and flat way. If any of you get to see the models in our class, you'll see that actually stroking the hair, you can't even feel that they've got extensions in there. It's that close to nature.
And they are, quickies are something that you can wash daily. It's almost like a permanent hair addition. It's not clip-ins. They last up to 8 to 10 weeks. And we do such a phenomenal amount of business in our salon with quickies. As Chris said, it's an hour, max hour and a half, and you can extend the hair as long as you want and have as much volume as you want. And all these girls had much shorter hair to begin with.
I've mentioned to clients who fancies a quickie, and you know you're going to get the answer, yes please. So I mean, they've got the right name as well. So ladies, thank you very much.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you. So what we're going to be doing next is kind of delving a bit more into the idea of icons. And what we did, we kind of looked into Hollywood at different kind of characters in the movies, and we kind of found four very distinctive characters. So what we did, we put a video together to kind of show you where our inspiration came from. We then did a photo shoot that was our first kind of piece of work we did with Hair Dreams, using the quickies, using some other of their kind of tools that they have, and being able to put pictures together so editorially we now have a story that tells the story you're seeing on stage, which is really about the influences of Hollywood but in a young and kind of more vibrant way. So let's take a look at our first set of icons.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all superstars. She wore my hair, put my lipstick on, in the glass of her goodbye. Never mama, love the moon, I should say, cause he made you perfectly. Give yourself prudence and love your friends. Stop a kid and choose the truth. The religion of the insecure, I must be a step, respect my youth. But a fellow is not a sin, but he's not a sin.
Blonde Bombshell. Blonde Bombshells have been around since the 20s. You know? Using pure peroxide in the hair was originally the way that they created blondes. But one of the most memorable Blonde Bombshells is Brigitte Bardot. So we used Brigitte Bardot as our silhouette, our shape. And what we've done here, I've actually used some of the tools that we have inside of Hair Dreams that we can actually offer our clients. But not just for a client, we can also do this in an editorial way, we can use it in a fashion way. We've actually got two pieces on the top of the hair here from our Volume Plus. And Volume Plus is something you can actually add to people who have fine or thinning hair. In this sense, we've used it really to kind of create more volume. I've actually got a top piece on the front that I've cut the fringe, and underneath that I've got a micro lines, which is something you can integrate the hair from underneath and actually give the hair more volume. So we've actually got two pieces on the top. Through the back of the hair, we've integrated some of our quickies in through the back to actually give a lot more volume and a lot more kind of thickness, because the hair's quite fine. And then dressing it this way, we kind of raised the crown again, gone back to that kind of 60s feel that Brigitte Bardot was known for, and again created that kind of sexy look that our Brigitte Bardot Blonde Bombshell is well known for, that disheveled, kind of just got out of bed look, but I mean, who gets out of bed and looks like that? But it'd be nice, wouldn't it? So ladies and gentlemen, this is Brigitte Bardot. So let's take a look at our next set. At the end of the video, what you'll notice is our before picture, our actual still pictures is part of our editorial, and then our interpretations that we're sharing with you on stage.
The French are glad to die. Love, they delight in fighting duels.
But someone else was to meet Satine that night.
But I prefer a man who leaves
Zedler's investor
and gives expensive checks.
The Duke.
I believe you are expecting me.
So you can see with the picture, hair's quite short, and what we've done here is we've used a combination of top pieces. We see this vibrant colouring here. What we've done is we've taken our quickies, which is almost like a sandwich. It's an adhesive top piece and underneath piece, using the hair to adhere the pieces to the hair. And we've coloured it with our Weller Colliston Perfect, our special mix. So the vibrant pieces that you're seeing here are used, we colour a lot of the hair pieces. Chris and I also use Weller in our salon, as well as Sebastian and Nioxin, and we've just coloured those pieces in through there.
So the reason we chose Louise Brooks is because she was a very strong woman. She was one of the ones in the 20s that actually revolutionised haircutting. So if you think about the classic bob shape that we really associate with Sassoons in the 60s, Louise Brooks was one of the first women that to cut up her long hair into a short bob and actually kind of go out there and stand up for women's rights. So kind of like a pioneer. That's the reason I wanted to choose the classic shape and then put the strong colours in there. But what I want to ask is, how long is your hair? Her natural hair is down to her, almost down to her elbows, and it's blonde. If I can turn you around, I'm just going to flash this up here and you'll see that what we've done with the pieces is fix them on top of her hair. We've braided her hair up, and then this is all kind of the top hair and the micro lines from Hair Dreams. So again, you know, another kind of way that you can actually utilize effects, especially when you're working with models. A lot of models have cards, they can't have their hair cut, and therefore you have to kind of create ways that you can use these tools that we have in Hair Dreams and be able to kind of change a model's hair up for us, for whatever we want to do, for photographs, whether it's a fashion show, whether it's something for, you know, an editorial magazine. In this case, you saw the pictures that we actually created using these pieces. So ladies and gentlemen, this is Louise Brooks. Let's take a look at our next icon.
This time gonna be good. Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all? Now shall you deal with me, O prince, and all the powers of hell.
Yes, her natural hair is actually this length, but it's much, much finer. So to get that volume, all we did was put in three sections of quickies in through the parietal area where the occipital is, and there's just three different rows. So what that did, it expanded her hair to give her a lot more volume. So that's what we're finding a lot in our salon, is it's not always length that people want, they want volume. So it can be used in many different ways, as well as extending different shapes. But we use Color Touch on our model's hair here, which is our demi-permanent color from Wella, to change her from being a blonde to a redhead. And it really suits her red. She's got beautiful skin tone.
One of the things we've also found is on any extension hair, actually using a demi-permanent color seems to really kind of be better for the hair than using a permanent color, because obviously there's no ammonia in a demi-permanent like Color Touch. So that's our color of choice that we, especially working with the quickies. So we found that these kind of looks are really getting more popular. We do live on the outskirts of Hollywood now. We live in Santa Monica, right on the beach, basically, in California. We've been there for 10 years. Our salon's been open for 3 years. We do classes in our salon. We actually call them train and tan, because basically after you finish training, you can put your bikini on and run down the beach and tan. because it's round the corner, which is really kind of nice. And we do a lot of individual classes for people. We do cuts and colours. We also work with Hair Dreams doing classes with them too. So if anyone's really interested in kind of knowing more about our education, we've actually got books and DVDs on the Hair Dreams stand downstairs. And you'll find it kind of located very close to the Goldwell stand, near the Weller stand, near Sebastian, yeah?
Yes, it's level 2,700, I think it is, exactly.
But for the minute, ladies and gentlemen, a really kind of like great twist on a Hollywood favourite, Jessica Rabbit, one of the best Hollywood villains we had in our movies. Let's hear it for Jessica Rabbit. So our last icon that we're going to share before we get into our next segment, basically, you know, we want you to kind of like take a look at the video, take a look at the inspiration, see where some of our kind of feelings of inspiration came from, and then take a look at what we've put together for you. Cleopatra, I think, over all of them, was actually the Queen of Egypt. You know, she actually ran a whole country, which, how many women in history have actually run a whole country, you know, especially back that far? So we wanted to kind of like do something that was a little larger than life, very avant-garde, very strong, and using the influences that you see in the history books of the different headdresses, I actually went for a shape that was very similar to a Nefertiti shape, which is kind of taken in very close, and then very flat through the back. What we've got here is two units from the Hair Dream Systems. We've actually got a top hair on the front. And what I've done on the inside, if I just tilt the head down, you'll see the light pieces that we have in here. That isn't a reflection. What it is, it's pieces of our quickies that I've put inside of the bangs. So inside the fringe, we've actually placed some of the little kind of sets of quickies to give different tones inside the hair. This is something we're going to be showing in our class after we finish here across the hallway. We're actually going to be showing how you can actually use the quickies to accent someone's haircut. In the back here, I've used a micro lines, which is generally used to really kind of thicken someone's hair up and give volume. But I actually set this on very tiny pins. So it gave this kind of almost afro texture to the hair that I then sculpted by pinning into the head and creating an anti-head shape through the back. Very flat and very wide. So you can see that it's very adaptable. It's something you can integrate with the hair and completely lose inside the hair, or something you can make something completely as a statement piece. So we're actually loving having the tools to be able to do. I want to take a minute just to thank this young lady, because, can I tell them where we met? I came in a couple of days early before the show, so I've been kind of like, I did the wardrobe for the show, kind of put together everything for the girls, the jewelry and the shoes and their looks. I just needed a couple of days, so I thought, if I'm going to Orlando, I'm going to go down there and either go Disney or Universal. Well, I came off the Hulk, you know that one that's like that, and went and looked at the picture that was there, and this young lady is the one that said, oh, do you want it or not, you know, do you want your picture? I'm like, are you a model? She goes, I want to be. So I'm like, well, would you like to do a show this weekend? She very kindly volunteered to come and model for us. This is her very first experience. Yeah. There, just so you can see how beautiful you are, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, this is Cleopatra.
That's great.
Yeah, so you can see the icons. We're going to take you through this in the class a lot more in depth, really kind of breaking them down a lot more. But for the minute, ladies, thank you very much. Thank you, our icons.
And we've still got plenty to show you because we're trying to show as much as possible. But as Chris said, we're going to show you all the different applications that Hairdreams has to offer. But at this moment in time, I'd like to introduce the third member of the Dubs team, Chris Cesarian. And Chris Cesarian, he's a Sebastian guest artist, he's a Sebastian artist, as well as a member in the Dubs Salon in Santa Monica. So Chris works in our salon, and just somebody asked me earlier before I came on stage, is it just the name, the Dubs Salon, or do you actually work in the salon? Chris and I, as well as our other stylists, we are open 6 days a week and we do work behind the chair every day of the week. So I just want to set that straight there.
Hi everyone. How's everyone enjoying the show? Well, like Sonia said, I do happen to wear a lot of hats in my career. I have the opportunity to work along with the Dubs, not only just on stage, but in the salon. And I also have the opportunity to go out to work on photo shoots and sessions as well. And one of the things that I find that has made my life a lot easier in that, and the photographers really enjoy, is when you're able to transform a model instantly and quickly. So having my top piece or my quickies all prepared and ready, I'm able to transform a model's look instantly and quickly, because we all know in a photo shoot, time is money.
So what Chris has put together here, we actually got a top piece last week. It was the lightest blonde in the top hair. And the top hair is a very flat. So if someone has, like a younger girl, because we're finding a lot of our clients in their late teens and early 20s are actually losing hair. You know, if you look at them, you can actually see that they're starting to kind of get some thinning through the hair. A couple of our clients, I think, are only 21 and 22, that actually have these pieces, these top pieces, actually adhere to their hair, so they can shampoo their hair daily and actually work with it. Obviously, it's not dressed in this elaborate way because, you know, who's going to be walking around except Lady Gaga with hair like this? And she does. But, you know, we're using them a lot in the salon. Sometimes people would prefer them to be clipped on so they can actually wear them daily, take them off in the evening. And some ladies actually like to have these kind of adhered to their hair, and they're adhered with a very fine fuse that goes through the hairpiece, and the hair's wrapped around and fused together the same way as we fuse the permanent hair extensions. Every 6 weeks they then come in to have their colours retouched. We take the piece off, or tighten the piece up, you know, so they can go a few more weeks. Some people prefer them taken off after 6 weeks, some people go a couple more weeks. But we found that actually our younger client base has actually built up more than our more mature, which is a shock, because you think more mature ladies will be losing more hair. It just seems the other way around. I don't know what it is, if it's hormonal, if it's something in the meat we're eating, or the food, or whatever, but that's the way it is. What we did here, the hair was pre-lightened. We did a pastel toner from Colourstone Perfect over the hair to kind of give this smoky blonde. And then the coloured pieces you're seeing in there aren't the hairpiece coloured. They're actually quickies that we coloured. And then we actually stuck one side of the sandwich that the quickies are made of, the little sets, underneath the hairpiece, and with a crochet hook, pulled the hair through. Because there's some integrating kind of spaces in the quickies that you can actually pull the client's hair through if you want to integrate that hair in with the unit you're going to put on there. So that's the way we did this. We decided we want to do something that's a bit larger than life. Obviously our models are brunettes, and we're making her more of a smoky blonde. So you can kind of see that, again, the transition and the change of, and the contrast you can kind of create very quickly. Chris worked on the piece last night, actually, just before we left after all our prep, to kind of get this ready, so it's been stored in a little box. But you can see, if you're doing a photo shoot, how easy it is to have pieces ready to be able to use on the same model. So you're just using one model, maybe 6 or 7 looks for a photo shoot. If you're paying for the model, you may as well get out as many looks as you possibly can.
Also, I'd like to add, Chris and I, if any of you have ever worked with us or been to any of our classes, we really love meeting people. So we're going to be on the Hair Dreams booth downstairs all day long, intermittently, as well as the class. But also, please visit us on our Facebook. We have a Christopher Sonia Dove Facebook page, and we really answer a lot of questions. If there's any questions about anything, we show our collections, and we always update it daily. And in fact, what we're going to do this weekend, the first 20 people to Facebook us and say Premier Hair Show Orlando are going to receive a book from Christopher and myself, complimentary, and we're going to ship it to you. So, Christopher, Sonia, Dove, Facebook.
And it's Sonia with a Y. So it's Christopher, C-H-R-I-S-T-O-P-H-E-R. Sonia, S-O-N-Y-A. Dove, D-O-V-E. Facebook here.
Yep, that's great.
So you can see kind of like very, very quickly, we kind of like put the image together, the look together. But we have also kind of like had an association in Hair Dreams with a fashion designer from France, Paris, France. You want to say his name?
Yes, his name is Charlie Lemandou.
He's actually originally a hairdresser. So get this, a hairdresser that worked with extensions that has moved into the couture world of fashion. His work recently has been seen on Lady Gaga. I don't know if any of you have seen the pictures recently where she's wearing a pink flamingo dress and it's got a bustle on the back.
Made of hair?
Made of hair. Made of Hair Dreams extension hair. He's also had a whole collection that he's made with Hair Dreams extension hair. So a hairdresser becoming a fashion designer using hair as part of his design. So what we've actually managed to do is secure a few pieces through Hair Dreams from Paris, and we're going to share them with you this evening. And you know, just remember, this was a hairdresser, fashion designer, now kind of like he's worked on Lady Gaga all over the world.
So remember, last seen on Lady Gaga, you're going to see it in a minute.
So ladies and gentlemen, enjoy Chris's creation here, and also enjoy the work of Charlie.
Learn how to.
Welcome back to the stage, Christopher, Sonia Dove, and Chris Rosario.
So ladies and gentlemen, I want to say a big thank you to the models. I mean, can I give them a big applause? We're going to look forward to spending more intimate time with you in our class. Our class is going to be a time. Thank you very much, models.